The last stage basically of our design is routing. So at this point, all the cells have been placed, the clock buffers have been inserted, and clock tree has been routed. Timing, setup, and hold are evaluated based on global route parasitics. But it's time to now route all of the signal nets, and that we're going to do with either the nano route form, okay, which we see here. We can run global route and detailed route, and we can say how many iterations we want to run, and if we want it to be a post route optimization and optimize vias and wires, fix antennas, do all kinds of stuff over here. If we want it to be an ECO route, if we want to do an area route where we can select an area to reroute, all kinds of stuff like that, how many CPUs to run on and stuff. Or we can do all kinds of set DBs, like set DB route with timing driven true, route with SI driven true, and then route op design, which again is going to do a concurrent routing and timing optimization. So it's going to route the signals and then run timing optimization and reroute and run timing optimization versus just doing a non-timing aware kind of route design and then do timing optimization on top of it. So route op design is going to do this concurrently. Next, we're going to go over to routing. So we have our clock tree now and we can go over to the route design. So I'm going to start stage route over here. If I didn't already delete the M2 stripe blockage, which I did, I would have deleted over here. Okay, I have, again, lots of get DBs, lots of DB options for route design, so I can do, look at those. But I'm going to set design route, set DB route design with timing driven true. That means I'm going to be doing a timing driven routing, SI driven routing, and I'm going to use multi cuts. What set the effort for that is. I'm going to give a name for the instances, and I'm going to use the route op design command, which again is this integrated routing and timing optimization in one. This is a change that was inserted into Innovus several years ago to do this concurrent placement, concurrent clock tree, and concurrent routing. In fact, physical synthesis is actually a type of concurrent synthesis. And then let's run route op design. And now it will run for a while and do a global and then a detailed route. So again, routing is something that can take a real long time as it goes and runs several iterations until it reaches a DRC clean. And since it's route op design, also trying to get a zero slack design, type of a solution. Here it's going to run quite quick, but even quite quick is a couple of minutes. Okay, so our design has finished routing now, and we can look through the log file, but I don't know exactly what you're going to find inside. When these things take hours and hours to run, you can kind of see what's going on if it looks like it's going to converge and stuff. Here it was very quick, and we can go on with creating our reports. We can go through the reports that we sent. So let's go over and look into what we have in our report directory. So now we're going to be in this area of routing. We have the different analysis views. These are the timing. So the hold paths, and we see we meet hold, so that's good. We have, into out paths. There are no constrained paths. Into reg is met, reg to out is met, and reg to reg is met. This is a perfect situation, right, where we met all of our timing constraints. Okay, and we see with setup, we have a lot of setup. We have a lot of setup slack, interreg, reg to out. We're meeting everything, but that's just because it's a real simple design, and it is not very constrained. We have all kinds of other things: the capacitance, so there are no max cap violations; fan out, there are no fan out load violations; length, there's no length violations; SI glitches. So really, there's no problems here. We can see the summary shows us the total worst negative slack, total negative slack, etc. Max cap, max tran, max fan out. Okay, transition violation. So we see that our reports are all very good, and we can continue on to the next stage.
Once we finish routing, we're ready for sign off, and we can do some post-route optimizations for timing and design for manufacturing. So post-route timing optimization can be run by opt-design minus post-route minus setup and hold. Okay, wire optimization, so doing things like straightening wires, widening wires, spreading wires, will be run with route design minus wire opt. Via optimization, which is reducing the number of vias and adding multi-cut vias wherever possible, is going to be done by route design minus via opt. And we can prepare for sign off by adding fillers. So we have to add fillers in our design, and we better do a route ECO minus fixed DRC to fix any DRCs that were caused by adding fillers, run DRC and LVS, so check DRC, check connectivity, and finally to export our design. So we're going to export our Verilog netlist with write netlist. We're going to export our SDF file with write SDF. We're going to export our GDS with write stream, and there are many other things that we can export from our design.
We can continue on to the next stage, which is post-route optimization. In fact, we wouldn't really need to run post-route optimization at this point because we met everything, basically. But we would run a opt-design minus post-route minus setup and hold. Okay. After we finish that, we would change our DBs to turn off timing-driven routing. Okay. Turn off SI-driven routing. But go on to all kinds of DFMs like spreading the wires and multi-cut vias. Okay, and then do a wire optimization and a via optimization. Okay, and then turn those back on again. By the way, you may be running such like iterations of routing and then and rerouting and fixing DRVs and so forth over and over again until we finally get what we want. And you have to go and look at your different DRCs and go and fix things.
So as a summary, in this demonstration, we covered a full block level place and route flow. We imported the design to Innovus. We created a floor plan. We ran standard cell placement. We synthesized the clock tree. We routed the design. We ran post route and sign off. But this was a really simple design. We showed a lot of functionalities of the place and route tool, and we demonstrated the complete flow. But now we can go over to a larger, more complex design and show off more capabilities.